Hello. Welcome back to V.AWAMPIE channel. Today, we're going to discuss Log and HLG in the DaVinci Resolve editing environment, specifically when creating HDR videos. Firstly, my editing environment is Windows and DaVinci Resolve 18.5 with an NVIDIA 3090. I also have a monitor that supports HDR 1000+, and HDR is correctly enabled on Windows. The demonstration video was recorded with the DJI Ronin 4D. This is just for reference. Before we start a new project, one thing we need to do is determine the color mode of your video. If you've forgotten, don't worry. Here's what you can do: right-click on the file, select Media Info from the pop-up menu, and check the original information to find out what your settings were. If you do not have Media Info, you can download and install it from mediaarea.net. It is a very simple open-source cross-platform plugin. If you see BT.709 under Transfer Characteristics and Color Primaries, then it's Log Color. For comparison, let's examine an HLG file. If you see BT.2020 in HLG in this section, then without a doubt, it's HLG. Yes, you might have figured it out. In order to meet the production and rendering requirements of HDR videos, 709 needs to be converted to 2020 in DaVinci Resolve. Okay, now, if it's log, like D-log, Z-log, S-log, etc. We click on the gear icon in the lower right corner to open the project settings. Then, select Color Management. In Color Science, we change it to DaVinci YRGB Color Managed. If you're lazy, keep Automatic Color Management selected. Then change the color processing mode from SDR to HDR. In the output color space below, change it to HDR HLG or HDR PQ. However, I do not recommend this. When you have various video files with different color settings mixed together, it can cause confusion and make you feel disoriented. Uncheck the automatic color management, and we will manually select it. Choose the HDR Rec. 2020 intermediate mode. This is suitable for various log color environments. If you're log, choose it. The output color space below should be set to Rec. 2020 ST2084 1000 nits or ST2084 1000 nit, depending on the brightness of your screen and the HDR brightness specification you are preparing to produce. If you're aiming to achieve a brightness of 1600 nits, increase it to 2000, and so forth. In this video, we are preparing to produce a video with a brightness level of 1000 nits, so we will select 1000 nits. Then check the box for HDR mastering for 1000 nits. The specific value can also be adjusted based on your production requirements. If you plan to produce video with Dolby Vision, select Enable Dolby Vision and adjust the brightness settings. Enable HDR 10+ and HDR Vivid. Save the setting. That's it. Now, let's talk about the HLG environment. Based on my personal experience and preference, I prefer using HLG for my filmmaking, and I currently utilize HLG settings. The initial steps are the same, where we modify the color science to DaVinci YRGB Color Managed. Next, for the color processing mode, we select HDR Rec. 2020 HLG, which is specifically designed for the HLG environment. This is where HLG differs from log, but everything else remains the same. Now, let's discuss how to output HDR videos. Switch to the Deliver page. Set the file name and the output location. Here, I will mention some key settings. Choose QuickTime as the format. In the codec section, select H.265. In the encoder section, if you have a powerful graphics card such as the 3090 or 4090, the NVIDIA options are worth considering. don't forget to check Export HDR10 metadata. Embed HDR10 metadata. Embed HDR Vivid metadata. Now, the crucial point is the encoding profile. Please select Main 10 as it is a requirement for HDR. Finally, click on Add to Render Queue and render your final product. It's as simple as that. This is my current setup for creating HDR videos, and I hope it can be helpful to you. If there are any areas that require correction, please inform me. I wish you a pleasant day. Until next time, take care.